Good afternoon. You may have seen another video that I've done in the past, over a year ago, and I've done very few videos. I was looking for an Android USB-C dongle that would allow me to receive TV signals and basically use my cell phone as a TV with an antenna. I knew that they were out there and I had seen them on YouTube, but unfortunately at the time, a year ago, you can go check on the story behind that. That did not turn out well. I'm here to report I've had success, but I also have to give you a very big caveat right up front. Do not plan to buy one of these devices unless you can confirm your cell phone or the tablet that you intend to use with it supports OTG. You must ensure that the hardware and the software that you have installed on your device supports OTG. If it does not support OTG, you're wasting your time and you'll aggravate yourself. Don't waste your money. Don't waste your time. Make sure that whatever you plan on using supports OTG. If it does, then this is something that you can consider. Now, this particular model is made by iView and it's labeled ATSC receiver. The picture is as what's in the box. Simple enough, came like this. There's the instructions. They're simple, they're straightforward, and they actually do tell me what to do. This is where the dongle device was attached. This is the dongle. Simple enough, USB-C and a jack for your antenna to go into. There's a small antenna. I have not used this, but it's there in case you want to use it as an alternative to the larger antenna, which I tend to prefer. I've already gone through the application loading, but I'll talk about that in a second. This is an example of what the antenna looks like. It's telescoping. Now, you'll notice it's magnetic, so it has a magnetic base in case you need to attach it to anything like the side of a car or something like that. And of course, it extends like this and bends. So it's simple enough. It's like old AM or FM radios that used to have those. The cord is about 6 feet long. I'm just going to mount it to this piece of cutlery to make sure that it doesn't go anywhere. And we'll set it out of camera view. Now I plug this into the dongle. Unlock my phone. And I'll show you the app. This is the app itself. It's called ATSC Player. When you select that from the Google Play Store, you'll notice that Sedona is a logo inside of this application as it downloads, and Sedona must be like the software company that developed it. More power to them. The download is straightforward. I didn't think you wanted to be bored with that. So we hit open. Simple enough. It gives you a screen to tell you to attach the antenna. So we just make sure we get our USB orientation correct. I always get it wrong, first try. Get a prompt, acknowledge. Now, in your first setup, it always does a full scan of all the stations. I've already done that, so I'm gonna save you the hassle of having to watch that exciting footage. But this is what it looks like initially for the channel list, and you can see there's a pretty sizable list of what I've been able to find signal for. Now, I have to tell you that not all of these are completely open to view. Some of them are encrypted and require you to pay a subscription to another service to be able to connect to them. I only worry about the most important ones like NBC, ABC, and Fox affiliates that are local. Okay, so just as an example, we'll open this up. Okay, so here's a broadcast here. Let's not dwell on the material, but you'll notice that at the top it gives you the station identifier. It has a red button down here which you can use to record the show. Currently I have the audio turned way down.
How many of you know that if I've got a power of attorney,
so if you have good sound that can come out of your phone, you'll have good sound coming out of the broadcast. All right. So then you have a full screen option and a smaller screen option, which seems kind of ridiculous considering the way this is formatted. There's an audio track, subtitles, and video decoder. Clearly I don't have subtitles turned on. You touch the center of the screen, it gives you another option. You can go over here to the side, and this is a shortcut to all of the station identifiers that were captured on your initial scan. Okay. So that allows you to short cycle between stations. We'll jump to one right now. Easy enough. We'll jump to the next one. Easy enough. And now we see a little bit of the Olympics. I won't stay on any of these stations too long because I don't want to infringe on copyright. But let's simply say that I'm very pleased with how this is all turned out and what it looks like. The video is clear. For those of you who are familiar with receiving over-the-air transmissions, at least in the United States, some of the transmissions are superior to what you can get via normal cable. Even if they call it 1080, it seems to be even clearer when it's over the air. But you do have to put up with the heartache of whether creating a problem. As you might have seen, there was a little digitizing of some of the broadcast. I have very bad weather going on right now. But that's it in a nutshell. It works fine. Remember, you must have an OTG capable Android operating system and an OTG capable phone. So if not, don't bother. It's not going to work. And beyond that, I'm looking forward to giving this a try while I'm on the road traveling or while I'm on the road camping. And those were the primary reasons why I bought it, because with it being such a tiny little thing, I'm seriously looking forward to actually using it while out and about. And that's pretty much it. ATSC receiver, brand is iView. I'm going to include an Amazon, a link to Amazon in the description below. Y'all have a good afternoon.